So what limits the number of thread blocks that an SM can run? Let me digress a bit to answer this question, which leads into the related topic of occupancy. You'll hear this term a lot if you pay attention to the CUDA forums or if you watch presentations on optimizing CUDA code. Each SM has a limited number of resources. There's a maximum number of thread blocks allowed on an SM. Turns out to be 8 on current GPUs. There's a maximum number of threads that a single SM can run across all of the thread blocks on it. This number ranges on modern GPUs from about 1,500 threads on, for example, the Fermi-based GPUs that you use on Amazon, or up to 2,048 threads on the Kepler GPU in my laptop. Every thread running a given kernel takes a certain number of registers, and there's a total number of registers for all of the threads on the SM, equal to 64K on most GPUs. And finally, there's a limited number of bytes of shared memory. This is going to be either 16K or 48K on modern GPUs. There's a maximum number of 8 thread blocks. Usually one of these other things is going to get in the way first. The total number of threads that you want to run across all the thread blocks, the total number of registers that each thread is going to take, and the total number of bytes of shared memory that each thread block wants to use. So for example, if I'm running on a GPU with 48 kilobytes of shared memory, and a single thread block in my kernel requires 16 kilobytes of shared memory, then I can run at most 3 blocks on that SM. Now if that same GPU has a maximum number of threads of 1,536, but my kernel takes 1,024 threads, then I can only run 1 block per SM. So in this case, even though my kernel took little enough shared memory that I'd be able to get 3 blocks per SM, the sheer number of threads in my kernel is preventing me from running more than 1 block per SM.